Welcome back. We're still live on Urban Today, and we're moving on to another segment in the second hour. And this time we're getting into Is That So? And I'm joined by Derek. Derek, how are you, by the way?
Good. How are you?
Not bad. Today you've just relaxed the whole 1 hour.
Yeah, I was just looking at you guys.
You know, those, I could hear somebody snoring, and I'm wondering, who is that?
It must have been Farouk. There's a time Farouk was sitting.
No, Farouk, there's somebody he's hitting on outside there. Hey. So he keeps on dashing in and out. I don't know what's going on with Farouk.
Then I don't know, because there's a time I also dashed out of the studio, so maybe some other guy right there. What's your point? Can you believe me?
Anyway, I don't know why. I don't know what people do on Monday evenings, because that's the only reason you'd be in the studio sleeping. What were you doing on a Monday evening? Don't go out on Monday.
No,
do they
don't. I was home, you know.
Oh, please. This is Uganda. Ugandans will go out any day, any time. Just as long as they have the money.
Yeah.
And every, there's a place to go to.
Every day is a good day to go out and
now,
have a drink.
That is one of those crazy facts of Uganda, by the way. I think that the whole world should know. Ugandans will party, will find a reason to party. Any reason. Wakanda, the rainy season, floods.
We still party.
There's always a reason to party. Welcome to Uganda. But
we're a blessed nation.
Very true. In our pastor, Is That So for today. One day. I feel stupid
like
saying this
story.
One. So, even if you, one day you were born, you were born, your mouth carried you for like 9 months, and then, breastfed you, you know, took you to school. But anyway, all these procedures, one day your parents, whatever, one day your parents will put you down and never pick you up again.
Yeah, very true. One day your parents put you down and never picked you up again. Literally, there's one point where your dad carried you and put you back down, and that was the last time he will ever carry you again.
I'm trying to think of reasons.
There's no way. Wait. I thought about it as well, but I couldn't find the day when my dad is going to lift me up again.
I think if I ever get into a relationship and get and decide and tell my dad I'm getting engaged, I think he'll carry me.
No, he's going to hug you.
He'll be like, what?
He's going to hug
you. Come,
I
carry
that's
you, my
child.
That's
the simplest thing he will do. Just
think
hug
he's
you
carry
like
me.
This and that's it.
Because I think he's decided, this daughter of mine, from the day I put her down, that was the end. She was not going to settle down. But moving on swiftly, what is called a French kiss? In the English-speaking world, is known as English kiss in France.
It's the most confusing thing I've ever read my entire life.
So the English call it a French kiss, and then the French call it an English kiss.
So what is the story behind all this controversy? Why can't they go with one word?
I don't know, because we need to dig deeper into this, because maybe an English kiss is not the way as we imagine French kiss.
Exactly. But for them, from the look of things, it's like they all mean the same thing.
I mean, but even the French are supposed to be romantic, so how do you say
English kiss?
The English,
or maybe they
I don't
like
feel
the English
are romantic.
More romantic.
I don't think English are romantic.
Well,
they're really not.
I think it's debatable, you know.
Do you know anyone English?
No.
Have you watched their movies? Do they even... They're not romantic.
Okay, they try. But I mean,
they're
French,
not romantic.
The French will take it out.
Let's move on to history. Let's just leave the English and the French kisses.
All right, moving way back a couple of years, and of course, looking to this day, what happened? We go back to the year 1881, and this is to do with Sir Alexander II, who was assassinated on this day. Check out our short clip.
Tsar Alexander II, the ruler of Russia since 1855, is killed in the streets of St. Petersburg by a bomb that was thrown by a member of the Revolutionary People's Will group. The People's Will, organized in 1879, employed terrorism and assassination in their attempt to overthrow Russia's Tsarist autocracy. They murdered officials and made several attempts on the Tsar's life before finally assassinating him on March 13, 1881. As Tsar, Alexander did much to liberalize and modernize Russia, including the abolishment of serfdom in 1861. However, when his authority was challenged, he turned repressive and he opposed movements for political reform. He was succeeded by his 36-year-old son Alexander III, who rejected the Loris Melikov constitution.
There you have it, with some of the amazing and history that happened the year 1881. And then, of course, moving on closer to the year that most of us could easily relate to. This is the year 2005. Disney names Robert Iger as the new chief executive officer or director. Listen to this.
On this day in 2005, the board of directors of the Walt Disney Company officially announces that Robert Iger, Disney's president and chief operating officer, will succeed Michelle Eisner as the company's chief executive officer. As Disney's chief executive since 1984, Eisner was credited with expanding the company's reach into diverse realms of the entertainment industry, including animated and live-action films, theater and theme parks, with phenomenal success. Robert had officially joined Disney's senior management team in 1996 as chairman of the ABC Group, and in 1999 he was named president of Walt Disney International. Later, Robert was named Disney's president and chief operating officer.
Well done for Robert. He has been the CEO for, as far as we can remember, up to date, he's actually still the CEO of Disney. Well done.
He's actually made them quite a bit of money.
Yes, he has.
He's really made them quite a bit of money right there.
A lot of interesting animations coming in from that side.
And some of us are still yet to visit Disneyland.
Yeah, very true. But one day, you see, all these things begin with dreams. If you have a dream, you can always achieve it. Let me tell you, it's very good to dream. Very good to dream. But nevertheless, you see, the most confusing thing.
So you're dreaming of going to Disneyland. You have that dream. Who do you want to see? Mickey Mouse? Anyway, it's a family place. You can actually go and really
explore.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's not part of Walt Disney. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. And let me tell you, I cannot stand that thing. Eh? Dora the Explorer. Yeah. I think she's... She's
A4.
She's
very A4. Moving on,
swiftly. Let's get somebody a job. Yes, let's get somebody a job out there. And this time around, it's coming in from CRS. That's the Catholic Relief Services. Now, Catholic Relief Services carries out the commitment of the bishops of the United States to assist the poor and vulnerable overseas. The vacancy is for deputy finance manager. And so you need to send your applications and CVs to UG_recruitment@crs.org. It's right there on your screens, as you can see it. And the deadline, of course, is Monday, the 19th of March. So you still have a lot of time this year, not next year. Monday the 19th. Mm-hmm. You really have a lot of time to actually send in your credentials. And all the best to whoever actually decides to send in the credentials and gets the job. Working with CRS, I think it's one of the most long-living or long-lasting companies I know. Mm. And they're all over Africa, so you never know. You could be here in Uganda, next thing you're transferred to another country.
And apparently the pay is really nice.
They pay really good. Yeah. They take care of their own.
And the beautiful part about it is that the workers don't strike. You know, was it last week?
With Catholic Relief Services, they relieve you out of your stress as you help relieve the stress
people
in the community.
You know.
So it's a very, very good, actually, company. That much I know.
We should apply.
We should. Who's applying?
We.
Mr. Kabushenga, he wants to apply for
at
that job.
Who, me?
Yes.
I was joking. Not applying for anything. No, I was just asking for a friend if we should apply before the deadline.
But you know, I've always wondered, like the way here at Urban, we're always giving guys opportunities to get jobs.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes I wonder, do people actually take it seriously?
I think they do.
I've seen in our newspapers, on our Facebook page, they always ask for people to come and audition for TV shows, or to come and host something, or to do social media.
Mm-hmm.
And I tend to wonder, do people actually come out and do these auditions? Are people nervous? Do people already judge themselves like, no, I can't do that job?
I'll give you
especially now for us here, because I know we've been looking for people.
Mm-hmm.
New talent, very fresh, not used talent, but fresh talent. I know that's what has been happening.
Yes.
Have the numbers been coming?
Yes, they have. I've witnessed a couple.
Be
of
honest.
Yes, I am. I've witnessed a couple of numbers of people who have actually come in. I've been part of the people to conduct their interviews, especially for the presenters. So we have a lot of more, and they're actually beautiful young girls, beautiful.
Of course, you have to begin with young girls.
Yes,
really.
These are the people we're looking for, young, energetic, fun, you know, fluent in English, and they always come through. You know, I've had a couple of them come through to do the news anchoring interviews. Farouk has been on the camera for that, and you know, he's always blushing.
So it had to be Derek and Farouk doing this.
Somehow, somewhere, you see, when you work with a big brand, which is
I think I should
today,
be called to do these auditions. I'm a no
joke. But
job.
Honestly, they've been
I'm
coming
no
through,
job.
And yeah, I think it's going to be a good one. So we're waiting.
So people are actually coming through.
Yes, they are. They're taking the job search very serious. And I think in about a few days from now, we'll have the finalists who will be called in to be, you know, told the final thing. So, yeah. And for the jobs that we actually give out, we've had a couple of people get on our Twitter and they ask us for where to apply.
I don't know if you've seen some of those details.
So I think, yeah, people do get take this job serious.
Because sometimes I do realize we can post for jobs and then somebody complains later that, and let me use where we are right now, like the media world, be it TV or be it radio. You can post and tell people, yo, we're looking for fresh talent in this, in whatever aspect that we need within the company. And then somebody's going to complain later when they find out it's Derek who got that job. But it's because he never came. I think they think it's a joke. So guys, take these jobs actually very, very seriously. And you never know, you could be the next lucky star, or you could be the next person as a deputy finance manager working for Catholic Relief Services, you know, things like that. So I'm going to leave the boys. It's my time to step out a bit of the sitting room, and I leave the boys to discuss anything and everything pertaining to sports. Oh my God, you better discuss the rugby sevens in Las Vegas. You see, I know something. See you guys in a few.